Now we're going to look at the same limit as x goes to negative infinity. Much of the computation is going to be the same, but there is going to be a couple key differences. We're still going to divide through by 1 over x cubed, because that's the highest power of x in the bottom. Square root of x to the 6th is x cubed. And we are still going to write this as the limit as x goes to negative infinity of 3x cubed divided by x cubed over 1 over x cubed, square root of 9x to the 6th plus x. Now in the top, it's still just as easy to simplify. We can cancel out the x cubes. But on the bottom, we now need to rewrite 1 over x cubed as something square rooted. And it seems like we would want to use 1 over x to the 6th again, like we did before. But here's the problem. We're going to negative infinity. So that means we're plugging in negative numbers. If I plug a negative number into 1 over x cubed, like negative 2, I get negative 1/8. If I plug negative 2 into the square root of 1 over x to the 6th, negative 2 to the 6th is going to be an even number. So I'm going to have square root of 1 over 64, which is 1/8. So I have a problem. This is negative, and this one's positive. And it happened right here at this step when we introduced the square root. So what do we do? Well, we have to kind of fix this. Because it turns out, if you take an expression like 1 over x cubed, and you square it and then square root it, that's the same as taking its absolute value. And taking the absolute value doesn't do anything if you're using a positive number. But if you're doing a negative number, and you want the number to still be negative when you're done, you have to put the negative in front of the square root of 1 over x to the 6th to fix the fact that you just took its absolute value. So we are going to rewrite our expression now as the limit as x goes to negative infinity, 3 over negative the square root of 1 over x to the 6th, times the square root of 9x to the 6th plus x. And now we're going to do the same thing as before. We're going to combine the square roots, limit as x goes to negative infinity, of 3 over negative the large square root, 9x to the 6th divided by x to the 6th plus x over x to the 6th, which gives us the limit as x goes to negative infinity of 3 over negative the square root of 9 plus 1 over x to the 5th, which has the form 3 over negative square root of 9 plus 0, because we're going to have right here 1 over infinity, which goes to 0. And so that means that our answer is 3 over negative square root of 9, which is 3 over negative 3, which is negative 1. So remembering to put in the negative sign in front of our square root is really important because it changes our answer from positive to negative.